This video is brought to you by ClearVPN. Do you know the little red button in the vehicle of Agent K in Men in Black?
You remember the little red button?
Yeah.
Push the little red button. And you may want to put on a seatbelt.
Okay. Yeah!
It turns out the option key on the Mac is like this little red button, or in our case, black or white, that you can occasionally use to add a bit of boost to your productivity. Ever since my latest Mac tips and tricks video, which I'll link at the end of this one, I got curious as to what will happen if I interact with the Mac using the option key all the time. So I used some tape and I'm here to report. I promise I will take it slow and I'll start simple. When you resize a window on the Mac, if you hold the option key, you will resize the dimensions of the window from its center point instead. I guess that's useful in some cases. By pressing the Option plus Command plus L keys, this combo opens the Finder app in the Downloads folder, my most used folder. Even though I've placed my Downloads folder as my default folder when opening Finder, this shortcut is the fastest way for me to get there. Okay, so I often use my Mac with an external monitor, and the quickest way to get to the display settings, to adjust maybe the positioning of the devices or fix a resolution, is to press Option plus either the brightness up or down buttons. This shortcut opens system settings and gets you directly in display options. Similar to this shortcut, pressing Option plus volume up or down takes you to the sound preferences on the Mac. This is great if you want to select a different input or output quickly, let's say while you are in a meeting. Following the same principle, Option plus Mission Control takes you to the settings of Mission Control. The rest of the function buttons don't do anything else. Trust me, I've tried it, and it's not worth wasting your time. Subscribing to the channel, however, is not a waste of time, so go ahead and do that, because why not? Now, let me share with you my absolute favorite shortcut I learned. Click on the notification center, the clock with the date in the menu, while holding options to toggle on and off Do Not Disturb mode. Now imagine you are in a meeting while you're about to close a client with whom you are sharing your screen, and you start getting messages from your mom. Just make the ninja move of holding the option and pressing on the clock, and boom, the person on the other side won't even know what happened unless they saw the embarrassing message prior to that. Anyway, when you copy an item, press Command plus Option plus V to paste it, which will essentially move it or trigger the so-called cut action. When working in list view in Finder, you have the option to expand the folders to see all nested subfolders and items. When holding the Option key and pressing the folder arrow to expand it, you can essentially expand all nested folders to see the entire content of the folder. When working on an app that allows you to save your progress, let's say on a document or an image, more often than not, you'll see the option to save the file, but where is Save As? To showcase it, hold the option while in the File menu, and you'll notice that Save As will appear. Depending on the app, it might replace the duplicate option or appear as an additional item, but it's there. Also, depending again on the app that you're using, the Option button might replace or reveal some other functionalities like closing all active windows. To dig deeper, in any app, you can hold the Option key while browsing through the menu items to see alternative options that you might find use of. Alternatively, when you right-click on something to reveal the secondary menu, if you hold the Option key, you'll most likely find additional functionalities that you can take advantage of. One useful example of this would be when working with files and folders. If you right-click and hold the Option key, you'll reveal the option to copy the path of the folder or file, which you can later use. Next, I went ahead and started pressing the buttons on the keyboard while holding the Option key to see what would happen. While going through the letters, I figured you could type special characters. You don't need to know them all, but it's worth remembering the important ones like Option plus R for a registered trademark, Option plus 2 for a trademark, or the most popular Option plus G for copyright. No need to Google them. The next tip is life-saving for me. If you often deal with files as I do, you most likely end up in situations where you drag a bunch of files from one place to another. Inevitably, you'll get to a prompt that tells you that such file or files already exist. And you can choose between keeping both, stopping, or replacing them. Well, most often that's not helpful because I want to move the files that don't exist and skip those that are already in there. Press the Option key while the prompt is active, and suddenly the button Keep Both is replaced by my favorite Skip button. Next, if you want to know more about your network, like your IP information, for example, Hold the Option key while pressing on the Wi-Fi settings in the control center and you'll find everything you need. IP address, router information, channel, and even noise levels. While on the topic of network, if you'd like to be sure that your data is safe and you're protected, you can lean on ClearVPN's AES 256 encryption and cutting-edge protocols and browse with ease. I use ClearVPN to change my location for those region-exclusive content streaming opportunities and move around the internet privately, accessing all the content I need. I can connect to any public network without any hesitation. Using the app is just a tap away thanks to the unique design and user experience. With ClearVPN, I can connect up to 6 devices to my account, which is more than enough for my needs. ClearVPN is available on ZApp, a platform with tons of premium productivity-focused apps and tools. For just $9.99, which is a fair price for a decent VPN service alone, you'll get access to more than 230 apps and tools for your Mac to help you solve thousands of other tasks, such as finance management, enhancing your remote work, and of course, securing your internet connection. Follow the first link in the description below or simply use promo code THISISE to take advantage of an exclusive 30-day free trial. Holding the Option button while pressing on elements in Control Center reveals further information. For example, if you press Option and the Bluetooth button, you'll see detailed information about your connected devices, including firmware version. Entering
danger zone.
While on the topic of some basic Mac operations, Command plus Option plus Delete immediately deletes a file without moving it to the trash. You'll get a warning for it, but still, be very careful because you won't be able to restore it.
Next, we get to Thanos level snapping the fingers power.
Option plus Shift plus Command and Delete empties the trash without a confirmation dialog. Although this operation saves you a few clicks, you should be absolutely sure you want to do that because it takes a nanosecond to realize that everything you worked on is gone, vanished. Next, when right-clicking on an app in the dock, you can reveal the Option menu of the Option menu while holding the Option key. And this way, you can quickly get access to the Force Quit option or simply tell all other apps to hide right away. Moving on to the next helpful tip. When pressing the Option plus Command plus D, you can quickly hide and reveal the dock. This is very handy when working on a project or you're jumping into a meeting where the dock gets in the way and you want to quickly get rid of it just for a moment. Once you finish the meeting, Option plus Command plus D brings back the dock again. When typing, Option plus Delete will delete the word to the left of the insertion point. Option left arrow will move the insertion point to the beginning of the previous word, and as you can expect, at this point, Option right arrow will move the insertion point to the end of the next word. Basically, you can use the Option and arrow keys to move around one word at a time. In terms of controlling the Mac, Option plus Command plus Power button will put your Mac to sleep. Alternatively, Control plus Option plus Command and the Power button will quit all apps, then shut down the Mac. Now don't worry, if you have any open documents that are unsaved, you'll get a prompt asking you whether you want to save them or not. Now, let's talk some more granular control. Option plus Shift and Brightness control will adjust the brightness in smaller increments. The more useful Option plus Shift combo to me is the one with the volume control, where I get some more granular control over my listening experience. While on the same combo type, Option plus Shift plus keyboard brightness will adjust the brightness of the built-in keyboard at more refined increments. Next, when you grab a file to move it to a new folder, if you hold the Option key, you will create a copy of the dragged item. You can be sure that will happen because a pointer will change upon holding the Option key and a green plus icon will appear. Alternatively, if you want to create just an alias to whatever you're dragging around, you can hold the Option plus Command and an arrow will appear. This way, you'll create a shortcut. In Safari, when scrolling, you can use the arrows to go up and down a long page. If you want to up the increments of your scrolling, you can hold the Option while pressing the arrow keys to scroll in larger steps. If you hold Option plus Tab, you can move around the buttons inside of a web page and ideally browse without using the mouse. If you enjoyed this video, you'll definitely find something new to learn in my latest macOS tips and tricks video, like the ability to showcase your inputs and outputs in Control Center. Like and subscribe, and even subscribe to my newsletter. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.